गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, माय नेम इज डॉक्टर रमनदीप सिंह। आई एम फाइनल ईयर पीजी रेजिडेंट एट मौलाना आजाद मेडिकल कॉलेज। द टाइटल ऑफ माय स्टडी इज कोरिलेशन ऑफ हाई रेजोल्यूशन सीटी सेवेरिटी स्कोर विद पल्मोनरी फंक्शन टेस्ट्स इन पेशेंट्स विद इंटरस्टीशियल लंग डिजीजेस। इंटरस्टीशियल लंग डिजीजेस रिप्रेजेंट ए हेटरोजीनियस ग्रुप ऑफ डिफ्यूज पैरेन्काइमल लंग डिजीजेस विद वेरिएबल इटियोलॉजीज, क्लिनिकल फीचर्स and radiological patterns and is challenging to diagnose. Chest HRCT is currently the gold standard technique for the diagnosis of ILDs. Pulmonary function testing is often used in management of patients with ILDs. The pattern of lung function impairments helps to assess the severity of lung involvement. Only a few studies were conducted in past to correlate HRCT severity with pulmonary functions. The aim of our study was to correlate HRCT severity score with pulmonary function tests in patients with interstitial lung disease. The study was conducted in Department of Radio Diagnosis at Maulana Azad Medical College and Associated Lok Nayak Hospital, New Delhi. The patients more than 18 years of age referred from Department of Pulmonary Medicine were taken, and it was a cross-sectional study conducted over a period of 12 months and 25 patients were included in our study. Our inclusion criteria was patients more than 18 years of either sex with a provisional diagnosis of interstitial lung disease either clinically or on previous HRCT chest. Exclusion criteria were all patients of congestive cardiac failure, primary pulmonary hypertension, pulmonary tuberculosis or pulmonary neoplasia, patients who are unable to perform spirometry, pregnant ladies and acute exacerbation of interstitial lung diseases. Chest HRCT examination was performed by using a 128 slice MDCT scanner at full inspiration in the supine position at 120 kV. Axial images of lung parenchyma were acquired followed by coronal and sagittal reformations in the lung window. No IV contrast material was used and the parenchymal abnormalities on HRCT were identified and scored according to the Varick score. The Varick scoring system includes ground glass opacities, which was given the score of 1, irregular pleura, interlobular septal thickening or subpleural lines, honeycombings and subpleural cyst, and these five parameters were given the score accordingly as shown in this table. And the number of lung segments involved by these abnormalities were also considered and given the score accordingly. To accurately correlate the results, the scores obtained at HRCT assessment were expressed as a semi-quantitative scoring. Mild disease was considered when the score was less than 8, while severe disease was considered when more than 15 points were there. These are the representative axial and coronal reformated images in lung window of patients with UIP pattern of interstitial lung disease. Forced vital capacity, forced expiratory volume in first second and ratio of FEV1 over FVC were calculated using a spirometer. Values were obtained while the patient exerted his maximum effort to avoid any expected error in the diagnosis. The data collected were statistically evaluated using SPSS version 25. Quantitative data were expressed in mean and standard deviation, while qualitative data were expressed in percentages. Pearson or Spearman correlation coefficient was used to correlate between quantitative parameters, and p-value of less than 0.05 was considered statistically significant. Now coming to the results of our study. Majority of patients were below the age of 60 years and the mean age of patients was 48.28 years. HRCT Varick score parameters in ILD patients found in our study were: The most common was interlobular septal thickening seen in 96% of the patients, followed by ground glass opacity seen in 60% of the patients, followed by honeycombing seen in 44%, and irregular pleura and subpleural cyst were seen in 32% and 4% of the patients respectively. UIP and NSIP were the predominant HRCT patterns in ILD patients in our study. Hypersensitivity pneumonitis, sarcoidosis, and early UIP pattern were seen in one patient each. Based on Varick score, the patients were categorized as having mild, moderate, and severe disease. Most of the patients in our study were having moderate disease, and 5 of the patients were having severe disease. The mean of forced vital capacity was 1.36, forced expiratory volume in first second was 1.15, and their ratio was 87.96. Now coming to correlation of HRCT findings with pulmonary function tests. FVC was negatively correlated when compared to Varick score, and this correlation was statistically significant with correlation coefficient of -0.94 with a p-value of 0. Similarly, FEV1 was also negatively correlated with Varick score, while FEV1 over FVC ratio was positively correlated with Varick score. And this correlation was again statistically significant. This is the scatter plot showing correlation between FVC and Varick score. Here we can see the negative correlation between the two. There was significant negative association with a p-value of less than 0.05 between severity based on HRCT and pulmonary function test parameters of forced vital capacity and FEV1, that is, as the Varick score increases, there was decrease in FVC and FEV1. The study included 25 adult patients of ILD with a mean age of 48.28 years and male to female ratio of 2:3. Majority of patients had moderate disease on HRCT. Mean FVC was 1.36, and we found significant negative association with p-value of less than 0.05 between severity based on HRCT and FVC. To conclude, HRCT not only helps in diagnosis but also helps in severity grading of interstitial lung diseases and showed a significant correlation with PFT parameters. Hence, it can be used to grade the disease severity and thus helps in determining patient's prognosis, especially when the patient is not able to perform pulmonary function tests. These are my references. Thank you.